Hi everyone, this is Lokesh from Devil's Tattoos, and this is another episode of Devil's Tattoos product review. So the product that we'll be reviewing today is Cheyenne. And which machine is it? Let's see. It's the Cheyenne Unlimited 4.0, which is the latest wireless machine from Cheyenne. And I used it for 2 months, and I usually don't say this to every machine, but I think this will be the machine that I'll be using most from now onwards, because this is one of the best machines I've ever used. So let's start. So what all comes with it? Let's see. So we have the machine here with a thick grip. Here's a charger for both the batteries. And here are both the batteries. They are similar, identical batteries for a backup when you're working and if one goes down. So how do you put the batteries is, just unscrew this top part, this cap, and it's like a, you know, normal Duracell kind of battery, but it's rechargeable and of course higher voltage. So you just pop this in simply and, you know, put the cap back tightly. And yeah, you're good to go. Let me quickly wear the gloves. Otherwise my finger marks are there on the machine. So first of all, this machine has two modes. You know, this is responsive mode when it's blinking. And if you keep it, you know, if you hold on for 2 seconds, this light is steady now, the white one. So now this is steady mode. So what happens in the steady mode is, you know, the machine gets the constant power and voltage. The delivery is very constant, and the, you know, no matter how hard the skin is or how soft the skin is. But if you press it for 2 seconds, you know, this light starts to blink slowly. That means it's on responsive mode now. So the machine will adjust according to the skin. Now the second light here is, as you can see, this is yellow. Normally when the battery is full, this is white. When the battery is below 75%, it's yellow. When it's below 50%, it's orange. And then, you know, after 5 hours of constant work, it suddenly stops. And then you have another battery always, you know, you can pop that battery in, and the charger is here. So you can put this in charge in the meanwhile, and it takes, I think, 2 or 3 hours to charge fully. So you always have a backup, so you don't have to stop working. The thing with this machine is, there's only one button here for everything. As you can see, there's no other button here. So how do you increase or decrease the voltage? So it's a super, super creative and cool gimmick or trick that Cheyenne has done, which is, so I'll just quickly show you here. So that's the machine. I'll just put the needle also. Yeah, you can see better. Here's the machine. So if the machine is like this, it's at 8.8 volts, 90 hertz. 90 hertz is like, you know, the stitches per second or the cycles per second, CPS, how you say. So if you know, if you go by the voltage, then it's on 8.8 volt if it's like this, and it's on 90 stitches. But it won't change automatically. You have to press this button while it's running. So when you keep this machine straight while pressing this button, now, right now, it's running at 12 volts, as you can see there, and 140 hertz. That means in 1 second, it's going back and forth 140 times. So if you want the voltage to be a little lower, now, and if I move the machine right now, it won't change. It will stay on that. To change the voltage again, I'll have to hold this button, whichever position this is in. Say I'm used to, you know, I'm, say if I have to pack colors and I go a little slow. So I usually don't see the chart. I go by the sound of the machine and the vibration. So if I go like that, you can hear the sound of the machine. It's really low. It's right now it's 25 CPS and 4.7 volts. And try to hear the sound of the machine when I change this. So you don't need to have this chart handy. You will, you know, get used to it. Once you start using it, you will know, you know, like when you start, it's at 90 and you go to 100, 120, 140. If you're using thicker needles, then only you'll go higher. If you're shading, you know, depends on how you use it. So if I shade, I go a little slow. If I color pack, I'll go even slower. This is how I use it. Only for thick lines, I go at a high voltage. That too, not that high. So I'll just simply that. So this machine alone replaces the need for power supply, clip cord covers, foot pedals, everything. It's just this. Before it used to be, you know, a whole lot of five or six things. And now you can actually, you know, take this machine, sit anywhere and tattoo, you know, even on a mountain if you have good daylight and clean environment. So this has a USB, you know, port here. You can put it in any mobile charger or wherever you have a USB port. And, you know, these things will light up blue. When you put the battery in like that, you see this is blue, and it can charge both the batteries in one go. And you can see this one is white. So the one which is white, that means that is not completely charged. The blue one, if it turns blue, that means that battery is fully charged. When it turns blue in the charger, that means the battery is completely charged. And that will show here. And I switch on the machine. See, right now this is white. That time it was yellow. That means that battery was a little low. This battery is completely full. So it's white when it's full, then it'll turn yellow, then it'll turn orange, then it'll turn red or it'll stop. So I've not seen that stage where it stops, because, you know, I usually do 3-4 hour sessions, and it'll give you complete consistency with the voltage. It's not like when the voltage goes down, the machine won't slow down. It will give you the same exact voltage, same exact power till the time it dies. And one of my colleagues was using it, and the machine will go on full speed as much, you know, it's supposed to go, and it will suddenly stop. It will not go down, and, you know, it won't go slow while you're working. So it gives constant power delivery. Okay, to wrap the machine, you can simply take out this O-ring and put a clip, cut a clip cord sleeve, the transparent one or the blue one, where you can see this button. So I usually put that clip cord sleeve here, cut it here, and, you know, cover the machine with that. For the grip, you can either use this with a grip tape, which I don't recommend. I recommend, or you sterilize this grip every time, or you can use the Shane disposable grips, which are really, really good. Good for travel also. If I have to travel, I cannot sterilize my grips. I use those rubber grips, which I use and throw, really easy and really good on the hands also. Your hand does not get tired. Your finger don't ache after 8 hour session. So you do that, and this super cool travel case, you know, you can put everything as you saw before, and, you know, just put it in your bag. The whole tattoo kit is here, except for the needles. You can buy it in India through Tattoo Revolution and Tattoo Gizmo, two of my trusted suppliers. And yeah, super cool machine. I'll be using this machine from now onwards. Really, really good. And if you are into black and gray, I'll recommend you the 3.5. Everything else is the same, just the stroke is 3.5. Good for, you know, softer shading. This is more powerful, packing, solid lining. So yeah, my work is 99% colored, so I'll stick with this. If you're into black and gray, 3.5mm stroke, but the best machine you can use. It does not have a battery hanging out like other machines where you have to, you know, it's just like this super cool, simple, like a pen thing. So that's what I like about it. It does not have an extra battery hanging out, which, you know, gives different, which, you know, the balance is not as good in those machines, you know, as it is in this package. Everything is in this. So another machine I would like to show you is the new, this is a gift from Shane. Cannot show you right now. This is strictly for testing purposes, and it's my Christmas gift from Shane. So I'm testing this machine. Really, really cool. This is something which no other Shane machine has. Look forward to it. Maybe next year we'll disclose this when the machine gets released, and we'll review this also. But super cool machine, which I cannot show you right now. So yeah, that was all about it. If you have any other queries, feel free to call me or call the guys at Shane, and we'll help you with your queries. And thanks a lot. See you next time with another review.